Hello, welcome to Tabletop CP, where today we return to France, 1940, for another game of Chain of Command. Alright, so don't adjust your television sets. This is not a repeat. Yes, this is the same board that we just played last week, but that's intentional. First of all, I had to go out of town for work, so I didn't really have time to set up a whole new board. And I wanted to try this again, as last week's game was a bit one-sided. If you've seen that, you know what happened there. So we're going to try it again, a different mission, different forces, but the same board. Tonight it will be the turn of the British to try to put a stop to the Blitzkrieg of the Germans in this little town here. The mission we'll be playing tonight is Blitzkrieg from the 1940 handbook. The Germans will be placing 3 patrol markers anywhere along their edge, and they will get up to 3 free moves before the patrol phase begins. The British will be placing their patrol markers 2 feet in, anywhere along the line, 2 feet up, and whoever has a higher force morale will take the first move in the patrol phase. And the objective is for the Germans to get 2 units off the board. The catch, however, is that the British cannot bring any support in unless they spend 2 full chain of command dice. And if they do that, they can bring their support in. The Germans, however, can use a full chain of command dice to reduce the British chain of command points by 3. Support will be determined by 2d6, add 6 for the attacker, and the defender will get half of that. So for terrain, exactly the same as it was last week. A lot of hardcover buildings, and of course we got our Geek Villain Grassy Hill mat again. Very cool mat, does service for us very well. So aside from all the hardcover buildings, there's a softcover barn over there. These wheat fields are going to be softcover at all times, stationary or moving. These fences here are going to be similar to hedges. They're going to be softcover with a 2-inch visibility. Hardcover here, we have a small orchard here. That is going to be the orchard rules, soft cover, 6-inch visibility. We have one patch of woods over there with the woods rules, 4-inch visibility, and soft cover. And that will do it. Let's take a look at the forces. Begin with the attacking German platoon. This is the 2nd wave division. So last week we used the 1st wave division. That is a very strong platoon with 4 squads, 2 senior leaders. I mean, right out of the gate, that thing is just, it's very incredibly powerful. So we're going to tone it down a little bit. Bring in the 2nd wave division, which is only 3 squads, and the force morale for this one is -1, or first rating, I should say, -1. So we have Kopke and Westermann back. We have Kopke, the lieutenant, with pistol. We have platoon sergeant, Westermann is the lieutenant. Kopke is the platoon sergeant with machine pistol. We have a 5-centimeter mortar with 3 crew. And we have 3 squads, identical. We have a junior leader sergeant with MP40, 6-man rifle team, 3-man machine gun team with MG34. That's it. That's the German platoon. British platoon here is from the 51st Highland Division. This is the 1940, standard 1940 regular infantry platoon. They are regulars. They have a -1 force rating as well. So there's going to be no bonus or negative for either force when it comes to support points for force rating. And we're going to have a bunch of different patrons in here today. Since we have so many British patrons, we got enough that we can easily fill up a platoon with all the leaders. So we're going to do that tonight. So we'll start up here. Leading the platoon is going to be Lieutenant Harry Ilsden with a pistol. And assisting him is going to be the platoon sergeant Nathan Tudor. He's got a rifle. We have the 2-inch mortar, which is Andre's favorite unit in the game. We also have an anti-tank rifle. Now I just added this in here. Whoever's playing the British can elect to put 2 men on it. They give you an empty one, so you have to man it. I just put it out here. It'll probably be manned as it's a pretty nice weapon. There's 3 sections. Each section is identical. Normally there's 7-man rifle team, sergeant with, or corporal with rifle, and then a 3-man Bren team. But 2 of the sections have 1 man taken out of the rifle teams to make, to man the boys' anti-tank rifle. So we start with the green leader. This is Corporal Jeff Smith leading this section. Next is the blue leader, which is Corporal Alan Downs. And then last but not least is the yellow leader, Dan Beersford. So we'll try to keep track of all these guys and where they are in the game. And yeah, it should be pretty cool. I don't think we've ever named junior leaders before, but what the hell. We're going to do it tonight. So that's it. That's the briefing. That's the mission. That's the forces. And let's get started. All right, the players arrived. We have Robert's going to be taking over the German platoon attacking. Andre's going to get his beloved British platoon on defense. It's been a while since Andre's played the British, I think. But he was very excited to hear that he was playing the British.
With a 2-inch mortar.
He's got the 2-incher. They both have force morale 9. Robert's going to have 2 free moves before the patrol phase starts. And he's also going to be taking the first move in the patrol phase proper. And they've been briefed on the mission. Now we'll do the patrol phase. Phase. Robert wound up with a jump off point here, and then 2 in the wheat field, 1 on the edge, 1 here. Meanwhile, Andre wound up with a jump off point here behind this wall, behind the rat bastard, 1 in this building, and then 1 inside the barn over there. So well spread out on both sides, and they picked their support. Now we will do the plans. Alright, so we're doing the plan. I'm filming Andre's plan, so he's telling me how he films his plan.
So yeah, get it right, Travis.
Okay.
Alright.
So, what's your plan, Andre?
So, I always start off, British plan. All right.
Talking shit about me?
Well, I don't have to. Everybody already knows. All right.
So defending British, what are you going to do?
So obviously, I'm going to wait for the opportunity. So my points have been spent. I've got 2 minefields.
Oh, we better put those out too.
Yeah. I've got a barbed wire, I think. No, I've got 2 minefields. I've got a liquor cabinet, because who doesn't need a good liquor cabinet?
Right.
And 4 entrenchments. So it really kind of depends. I don't know what Robert's, if he's going to have any armor. I don't have a lot of anti-armor. I've just really got my anti-tank rifle, which I could put that in an entrenchment, or I can get 2 full squads in entrenchments.
Which would be really nice over there if he tries to rush through that gap.
Yep.
Just pop up there with a couple squads.
I've also got this hunk of wall here, and I could put an entrenchment, and I could be blocking the road if he's trying to motor up the road. From this building, I'm pretty sure I can come this way or pop out here, and oh, the fence is going to be a problem. But I do have 2 windows up here, so...
Yeah,
I've got good line of fire out that direction, potentially.
Yeah, if he goes through there, he'd be in a crossfire for sure.
Yeah, so I don't see him really making a big push out. That field is a lot of open ground, but I did get a jump off point into the barn just in case. And I've got enough entrenchments that I can, I think I can hold that corner. So... Yep. I'm liking the way this is playing out. Not that Robert couldn't come up with something that's really going to stymie me here, but I think I'm in pretty good shape. I'm a little worried about how much armor he might bring, but we'll see. So I do have my 2-inch mortar, but that's really going to be more if he brings a medium machine gun or some kind of anti-personnel howitzer that I need to,
block.
Something that I can block line of sight out of, and so that's more of an opportunity thing. Don't know that I'll get to use it like I like to, but...
Yeah, in the defense, it's not as good, except for, like, as you say, for blocking lines of sight from guns and machine guns and
depending
stuff.
Depending on what he brings. So I'm going to hopefully get a good chance to pop out lay down some serious damage as Robert's trying to make his way up. Maybe he'll just do a scout thing, which would be okay. I don't mind throwing 1 unit out, but anyhow, that's enough for me.
All right, so we'll let Andre put out his entrench or his defenses, and then we'll do the German plan. We'll do the German plan. We'll show you real quick where Andre put his two minefields. He put them over here.
Pretty much exactly where I expected.
Blocking the road and blocking this far right edge of the Germans. So now Robert is here to do his plan. So what did you bring for support to start with?
So, support, I have an adjutant, a mine clearing team, a wire cutting team, the 222 armored car, the MG34 on a tripod, and the 75mm infantry gun.
Cool. I think actually you can choose to bring what... I think you can choose what engineering teams you bring after.
Okay, then it'll
so
be
so you
two
can make
mine
it
clearing.
Two mine clearing teams.
Be two mine clearing teams. But yeah. Basically the plan is the infantry gun from this deployment point, because it can range it on the barn, so any defense there, and you can also see any of the tall buildings.
Yeah, that's not a bad... At least the upper stories, yeah.
Right, and which basically...
It's a good spot for it.
Good spot for it. And then...
plus it can move.
It can move. And then I've also got the MG34, which if he's creating a forward defense where this jump off point can see it, I can set it up. Basically, it's why I took the adjutant, so I can have the senior officer with the two gun teams to keep it going.
Right.
And then I can either push up... obviously, the armored car will come on the road, and that'll pretty much secure this flank with the mine clearing teams off that jump off point, because he's going to have to defend those mines fields from the right bastard.
Yeah, if you really wanted to make a push this way, you could put both mine clearing teams over here and make an effort to clear them.
With the armored car.
As
and
support.
Then I've also got, I can push through the woods. The only concern is, of course, this is an open.
Yeah, it's very open. Very open.
But they can easily maneuver undercover this way and then push this way.
Yeah. He didn't bring the Stuka.
They did not bring the Stuka.
And none of the shabby Nazi tricks.
Nope.
Your plan is pretty much set up a base of fire and try to clear these minefields?
Try to clear the minefields. I'm going to push on this side of the board.
This way? Okay.
Just because this is too open.
Right.
Unless, of course, I get lucky.
Don't forget scouts.
Yes.
This is a perfect opportunity to use scouts. Force him to do something.
Yep.
Don't get into a point where you're exposed and then suddenly a double phase happens and he pops out.
Yeah.
At their opportune time. Make them pop out early.
Right. So. Well, but there's also a lot of places here to set up good bases of fire to cover clearing the minefields. Like this fence. That one actually can probably be cleared from in cover.
Yeah.
I mean, unless he's in the rat bastard, in which case we just blow it up.
He could get into the rat bastard from this jump off point.
Which would be fine, because I can then blow it up.
Yep. All right, well, that's the plan. That's both plans. So we're going to let Robert take the first phase. It's equal force morale, but since he's attacking, we'll just let him go first. And that's it. So we will begin. So we're going to begin. I'm just going to say right now, we got the Wargaming World dice from Greg. They're banished. They're sent to the front line. They're going to be front line dice just rolling hits and saves now. They're too good, man. They're too good for double phases. So sorry, Greg. All right, so here we go.
Yeah, that wasn't a concern here, was it?
Nope. So we got 1, 2, 2, 4, 5 for the Germans.
Yep.
Robert just brought in the 2, 2, 2. That was it. He brought nothing else in. He did move flat out. So there's now the British phase.
Aren't I at 9?
Yeah, not 11. Andre's already
cheating. No cheating. I was just going to say, a Yahtzee of fives.
That's what you need.
Well,
1, 1, 3 and a couple of fives heading towards his first chain of command.
And Robert's up.
Double phase.
Here we thought we were getting rid of him by getting rid of the Wargaming World dice.
Five.
Well, how could you not get double faces with pink dice?
Yeah, that's true. Robert brought in the 75mm infantry gun there in the field. It's got good line of sight towards the barn, towards the rat bastard. And then he brought in a squad over there. Next phase. 2 threes and a one and a couple of fives. The end of the German phase.
Second German phase.
So he brought in the one of the mine clearing teams here. He had the junior leader for this section. Put the machine gun on overwatch. He sent a scout team out. They got a good run up to here. And then the last thing he did was he brought another squad in over here on Overwatch. So everything's covering the front of the Rat Bastard right now. Pretty much everything on Overwatch except for the armored car. British phase.
Look at all those senior leaders.
Four fours.
I can bring all four of my brass in.
Are you going to bring anything? I guess you can bring your two-inch mortar.
I can bring in the two-inch mortar.
But you can't fire it without line of sight. So you'd have to expose the two-inch mortar. Andre brought his two-inch mortar in here. A really poor roll by Andre.
I guess I should put him on Overwatch, huh? Oh, I can't. It's a one.
Yeah, he really needed a two or a three there, but a bunch of fours is, as Andre said, almost as good as another phase for Robert.
It was better.
Maybe not as good, but
no, it's
pretty
better.
Good.
If he'd have gotten another double phase, he would have had to drop a die.
Yeah, we're stopping at two in this game, by the way. Two double phases, you're done.
Oh, okay.
And you drop a die after the first one. After the last game, the double phase got a little out of hand. So.
Yeah, it did.
Anyway, okay, so you got 1, 3, 4, 4, 5. Kopke came in over here with the four. He ordered the mine-clearing team to move tactically. They got a 1 inch. He ordered the squad to move tactically. They moved up 3 inches. With the one, he brought in the MG34 and put them on Overwatch with Kopke as well. They're covering down that direction. And then with the last dice, he put this 2-2-2 on Overwatch. So a lot of Overwatch now covering down this side of the board. Now it is the British phase. You can do it. A 2 and a 3. Oh, man.
A 2 and a 3.
That's good. 1, 2, 3, 3, 3. So
that's about as good as it gets.
Andre could probably bring in his whole platoon. All Andre has done is brought in Corporal Jeff Smith into the Rat Bastard.
I lied.
And he's bringing Tudor in with him.
And I went a little too far.
Okay, so we have a squad now in the back. So he's off of the back. He's off of the windows. Can't be seen. No one knows he's in there yet, but he is on the board.
You don't know the squad. I'm here.
Half the section behind. Half the Bren team in, along with Corporal Smith, the squad leader. And then Andre's going to waste the rest of the roll.
Waste.
Sadly. All right. 1, 2, 2, 4. Germans, Kopke, he ordered the squad to move up tactically. Both, they got another, not a very good move. The rest of the scout team is now back in with them, though. There's no point in them rushing up. Kopke also ordered this mine-clearing team to move up tactically. They only made it to there. He brought his last mine-clearing team in. And then he brought Lieutenant Nils Vesterman in over here. With those guys, still got a squad off the board. And that's it. I did forget to mention the second wave division doesn't have the mortar. I think in the forces I was talking about them having the mortar. They don't.
Wow.
That's almost
same roll.
Same exact roll. Mm-hmm.
That is the same exact roll.
So you're going to waste this one again, I guess, because you didn't use the last one. So Andre has split off a scout team. So Corporal Smith has sent a scout team out, presumably to get line of sight for the 2-inch mortar. He is going to have the MG34 in the building, which is technically looking out this window here, but he's set up there just for practicality. Mm-hmm. And he is going to fire his Overwatch at that scout team, even fives.
Oh, I got five.
And, hey, I'll give you soft cover just for the two trees kind of in the way. Here we go. Dead in one shock.
Dead in a shock.
Okay, he's almost pinned.
I'm still within...
You're still alive. You're still alive.
Okay.
Could be a costly... We'll see. Okay, so that was just the three for Corporal Jeff Smith. So Andre's going to fire the 2-inch mortar now that he has line of sight with that one guy.
Effective range.
So we're going to try and land it, Andre. Launching a smoke round. So roll a d6.
It's effective range.
See if you land it. I think he does. Isn't it a 5 or a 6 and it lands where it wants without line of sight? Okay, so he's going to block the road. He threw a smoke grenade. He had Tudor throw a smoke grenade. Try to cover him, but it landed way the hell over there. And then he's moved these guys up just to get within 4 inches of that guy again.
Okay.
And that's it for the Brits. So the Germans.
Oh, goody.
That's a pretty good roll.
Yeah, it is.
A bunch of twos, a bunch of threes, four.
And a four.
First order of business. Platoon Sergeant Kocky is going to have the MG-34. See if he can kill that guy there. Needing fives.
That's two hits.
Two hits.
Two hits on that dude there. Soft cover, we said.
Soft cover.
Yeah, he's dead. But it's not team wipe dogs. We're saying he's part of the squad again. But
the shock goes on the squad.
The shock would go on this. If you had any shock, it would go on the squad since he was part of the squad again.
Okay.
Okay, so that's that. Lieutenant Vesterman ordered this squad up.
Yep, they're no longer on overwatch.
So they're on the way. The armored car moved up to the right of the smoke. Meanwhile, Kopke ordered the two mine-clearing teams around that side of the building. And I think that was it.
Oh, the squad's on overwatch.
The squad went on overwatch with the three facing the rat bastard. Okay, Andre.
Yeah, well, can I get three great rolls in a row now that I actually want to use one?
Three threes and one and a two. That's not horrible.
Yeah, not what I was
finally got
for.
Another chain of command dice.
Okay.
So two, three, three, four. Andre pulled the point of shock and he's going to bank his chain of command point. He's up to three now.
Oh!
Three fives.
Three fives. Four and a six.
Platoon Sergeant Kopke ordered the MG-34 that's in this window to go on to overwatch again. And then both of the mine clearing teams he ordered into the building. British phase. One, three, 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 six. First thing Andre is going to do with that one, he's brought in his boys, which is going to see the armored car. He needs a seven. Small.
Got it.
Small, low profile. Okay. So the five plus the two. So roll your two AP, Andre. He's got one. And Robert rolled one. So it's an equal hits, though. So Andre, roll another D6.
Equal
hits. Could do something. Oh, that's
probably good.
Equal hits, one shock, reverse, one D6.
I'll take it.
Yeah. There he sits. With one shock, he just pulled back 1 inch. And then Andre's still got a couple threes.
No, I get to shoot him.
Oh, that's right. An overwatch. Mm-hmm. The MG-34 in the window is going to fire.
So I need fives.
Need fives.
One, two, three.
Hard cover, Andre.
Three sixes.
Three hard covers.
Just one point of shock on the boys. Now Andre will finish his phase. Be it for Andre. Just the boys came in. Now it's time for the Germans.
Oh, good.
One, three, 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 four. It's a good roll.
What's my HE?
First thing first is the armored car with the three. Pull a shock. He's going to try to finish off or kill that boy's anti-tank rifle. HE 6.
Really?
Yep.
Okay.
You said it wasn't any
4 plus.
Good.
Well, I said I wasn't scared of HE 6.
Two hits.
Only two hits. See?
But you're in soft cover.
What are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Nothing. Not a damn thing.
Okay.
Okay, the MG-34 now. We'll take a shot.
Eight fives. Oh, that's five fives.
Hard cover, though.
He can roll five sixes.
You only need two.
I'm greedy.
I can't even roll fives. You want me to roll sixes?
Well, there's one. Just one dead and one shock.
One shock?
They broke.
I see they have a shock.
Oh, five. No, it's just a six.
Yeah. They had a shock and I lost a dude.
So you can't pin, but you can break if you take one more. After the shooting, Lieutenant Vesterman just ordered that squad up. They got to the fence, and then the gun is moved a little bit just to clear that smoke and get a better line of sight onto the rat bastard. Now it is the British phase.
One, four, five. Four, a five.
Look at this, Woo-hoo. Andre. No double phases for you yet.
I'm saving them.
I think last game you had, what,
I'm saving
seven
them.
Or eight?
I don't need them. I'm not like you. I don't use them when I don't need them. What's the point of just burning a double phase?
I'm sorry. Andre fired the boys. I thought he was moving.
Okay.
He
your hits.
Fired a shot. He actually hit with a nine. And he got one.
One.
Ooh, one net plus hit. One. So roll a d6 and...
I gotta find out what it is first. I can't just go look it up.
Four. Four. One net hit on a four.
One net hit on a four. One shock. Movement, fast, flat out, remove lowest die.
Ooh, you did some damage.
Okay.
So if you move flat out,
you drop the lowest die. The
lowest die. Okay, so that was a one, and Andre was going to move the boys as well.
So we got a two-inch move.
1 inch.
Because of the shock.
You got a shock. Oh.
Okay, so...
But I think that's all he needed really to get.
Yeah, get out of sight.
The machine gun in that building over there just barely had line of sight, so he's going to be out of line of sight pretty much of everything now. That's all Andre's going to do. That's the one boy's shot.
Oh, hey.
A couple more fives. So Robert's up to what? A dice and almost a second dice.
Yeah, so I'm at four.
One and then four, and then he's... What did you wind up with? Two threes. Okay. He's going to fire... he moved them over.
Yep.
They hopped over, and then he's used the last three to have the gun fire at the rat bastard.
Four hits.
Four hits, soft cover. And all that you have in there is the...
And what
the Bren team.
What do I have to do to damage the building? Three sixes or four?
I think it's three or three and four.
So one dead, and it's not a leader.
One dead. So one dead out of the Bren team. Yeah, I think you do need three to... I think three makes it unstable and four makes it collapse or something like that. So he's taking a shot at the rat bastard. Oh, double phase, Andre. One,
joy.
Two, three. Andre has had Platoon Sergeant Tudor has ordered took a shock off. The boys, did he order the boys over? Or the boy, you had a one, right?
No, I had a four.
So yeah, you ordered the boys.
I had a four and a three.
Yeah, you
ordered
the
boys over.
The boys came over, he restocked them and pulled the shock.
Yep.
But and then he moved everyone out. So
I'm
the rat bastard is now empty.
I'm going to restock the Bren team also.
You can't do that. I think all the orders from the senior leader are taken, yeah.
Okay.
But you do have another phase, so you could do it next phase.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can I do it with one of my senior leaders?
So you got three fours? I think you
so.
Pull it off.
Okay.
Andre, he had the platoon sergeant pull a man out of the rifle team and add him to the Bren team. Now we have a two-man boys AT rifle team, a full Bren team, but there's only two guys left in the rifle team.
Actually, while I'm here,
uh-huh.
I'm going to go ahead and hop the wall.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I think you'll make it. Okay, he's going to jump the wall. We'll go into the German phase.
Oh, two,
two, two and three fours.
Yeah.
That is it for the Germans. So Lieutenant Westermann has moved up behind the fence.
Mm-hmm.
He also put them on overwatch?
They're on overwatch.
And then this squad, he ordered them up into the house. Meanwhile, Kotke has ordered the machine gun back on overwatch. He jumped the fence, and then he ordered the squad up to the fence there, right across the street from the rat bastard. And that is it for the German phase.
We can put the roof back on the rat bastard.
We could, yes. Your phase, Andre.
And,
he's got a chain of command dice. And then two ones, or two twos and a one. With the one, Andre fired the two-inch mortar. So the boys has line of sight 2 inches past this fence, so he was trying to land it there. He wound up drifting over there, which completely blocked the road. And after that, Sergeant Tudor over there has just put everyone on overwatch.
Okay.
So, time for the German phase.
Hey!
Oh, three more fives.
Damn. Oh, yeah, that's another threes. Chain of command.
So you got two chain of command dice now and two threes.
Two hey. Threes.
First thing he did, with one of his threes, he put that squad on overwatch. The next three, he moved up in the top floor, and they can now see them. Andre is on overwatch, so he's got three rifles. This junior leader, Smith, and then the two rifles. Even fives. And then the boys.
The boys is the red die. So two hits with rifles.
Two hits, hard cover. Rifle team.
Rifle team.
Nothing.
Nobody cares.
Okay.
Not a damn thing.
Hey, I fired shots though.
Hey, Andre, you got to fire a
you
shot.
Did.
Well, you shot
did.
You shot the boys earlier.
Yeah. Well, okay. I fired at infantry.
Okay. First time firing at enemy infantry.
Woohoo!
So okay. Your face. You want to chalk that as a victory of some type?
Wasn't it?
1, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I used all my dice. Woohoo!
All right, so we had Tudor, the platoon sergeant, ordered the boys, and they're there now in the orchard. They move back, still within line of sight, though, of the guys in this house. And then the rifle team was ordered to run over there, and with the three, he pulled the shock off with the Corporal Smith. All right.
Okay.
German phase. So you can still see the boy's anti-tank rifle.
I know.
This is maybe not good, but maybe not horrible.
It's not good for him.
4 and 3 threes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what we'll have this senior leader is going to have machine gewehr onto the boy's anti-tank rifle. Need attempts.
Nothing.
Not a 5.
Okay. And then
it's an extreme angle.
Vesterman is going to have, for his first point, he's going to have the 4 riflemen fire at the boys.
Okay, 4 rifles at the boys.
5s.
2 hits. 2 hits. Uh-oh. Soft cover. Point of shock.
Okay, for his second point, he's going to order the gun up.
Vesterman moved the cannon up to there. The armored car also moved up. It's full move, 3d6, but it was had a damage from the boy's anti-tank rifle. We still made it up to the minefield. I think that's it. Slow advance by the Germans. Oh, end of turn. Oh, there goes all your smoke cover. Double phase and then a 3 and a 4. So Andre has moved his Bren team here. Rifle team is back here with Corporal Smith. And then the boys is now back here. He pulled the shock. And that's it. End of turn.
Yep.
All the smoke is gone.
Yep.
All the overwatch has come off.
Yep.
Now we move on to the next phase.
Okay.
2, 3, 3, 5, 5. Corporal Smith has just pulled everyone back into the orchard. So they're now back there, part of a squad, along with the platoon sergeant. German phase. A lot of twos. 4 twos and a 5, so no 3.
No, but I don't need it.
Kopke has put the machine gun back on Overwatch. He had that squad go on Overwatch, and then he had the one of the mine clearing teams ran out to the minefield. And over here, Vesterman has put them on Overwatch, moved himself over, and then the gun has moved up along the fence. British phase.
Wow,
3, 3, 2, 4, 4s. Pretty good. The Germans have rolled 1, 1, 3, 4, 6. I cleared the mines.
So
I think you need a 6.
you
need to roll a 6, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. And then next time we'll say it's a 5. I think it's a 6 all the time, but we've added because it's
ridiculous.
It's damn hard. It's damn
and then
hard.
The other mine clearing team's gonna run up there.
Okay, so both mine clearing teams are gonna be at the minefield. One of them is partially started clearing. So Kopke has moved up and he's pulled the 2 shock off of those 2 mine clearing teams that sprinted earlier. That's it. That's all there is for the Germans.
That's it?
So he's finally on the move.
That's all they got?
That's all they got. 1, 3, 3, 5, 6. Andre's passing. 2, 3, 3, 3, 4. Pretty good. Kopke with the 4 is going to order the... So one of them needs a 5, so roll that first.
The white one's the 5. The nope.
Backwards.
You rolled it backwards.
Okay, a 4 and a 5 next time. Okay, so that was 2 of Kopke's orders over there. Kopke, that's all he's going to do. They're trying to clear the minefields, and then Vesterman just had them go on Overwatch the gun. Or no, I'm sorry, the gun commander put them on Overwatch. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. Andre's waiting, so he's obviously waiting for you to make a move here.
Got 2 5s, a 4 and a 1.
So you're 2 chain of command dice now, and then up to 5 more.
Yep. So, okay, Kopke's going to order them to clear the mine again.
Okay, so...
So, black needs a 5, white needs a 4. Got it.
Okay. That minefield is now clear. So Kopke... Robert actually used a 1 to do one of the mine clearing teams, saving Kopke 1 command.
And I will be nasty. I'm going to burn a chain of command dice to take away one of Andre's.
Oh, you're going to drop one of his by three?
Yes.
Okay, Andre, drop one by three.
Where's this coming from?
That's one of the rules. So he can burn one of his chain of command dice to drop one of yours by three, thus making it harder for you to bring your reserves in.
So this is a rule book someplace? Because we've never done it before.
For this mission. It's just for this mission. Yeah. Because remember, you have to have two chain of command dice to bring in any support, right?
Ah.
So that's a way to keep him from...
Me from getting my support in.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty then.
Okay.
He moved 1 point away.
That's why I did it.
He moved these guys up.
Mm-hmm.
They're up there now. Kopke went with them. They cleared the minefield, and that's it.
Let's pray I don't get a double phase and try and launch a counterattack.
That would be too tempting.
It would. Oh, I saw the six. I'm thinking, shit.
1, 1, 2, 4, 6.
Yep.
The only thing Andre is going to do is going to have the boys' AT rifle take a shot at, just a pot shot,
it's a four
at
to hit.
One of these engineering teams. So four up.
Nope.
That's a mess.
Unless I guess I could move the, yeah, but you're about to be in the rat bastard, so I guess that's probably not a good plan. Okay.
That's it. Andre's still biding his time. That's fine. He's okay. Defending.
Hey, I'm traveling.
He's defending.
Check it out.
Amazing, I know.
No wonder this game's going so long.
Normally by now as defender, Andre would be up in
the... Shit, I'd have launched two counterattacks as a defender by now.
Usually. So what'd you get here? 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay.
So something's happening here. Finally.
Something's happening here.
Kopke pulled some shock. He was going to make
what
a sprint around
exactly
the outside of the rat bastard line up here. Andre burned one of his two chain of command dice.
No, just one of.
Oh, the one that he has.
One. Yeah.
And pulled his jump off point back.
Okay.
All right. Now Kopke and his boys, they're going to make it. So they're going to make it all the way up to
they're
the
line
stone
up.
Wall.
Yep.
They're up here now?
Yep.
He ran them up to that minefield, and that was it.
Mm-hmm.
So now we got a squad here. You did burn one of your chain of command dice. And
I did that in my last.
That's it.
That's it.
Here you go, Andre.
Okay.
So Andre's obviously not too concerned about bringing in his reserves if he's burning his chain of command dice.
Oh, I can build another
one.
How hard could it be?
1, 2, 3, 4, 6.
Yeah.
Andre's bored. He's trying to drop smoke in random places.
Hey!
4 fives. And then the 2 and a 4. So what do you have? 1 chain of command dice?
2 chain of command dice.
2 chain of command dice plus one.
Plus one.
So sadly we missed it, but he did clear the minefield on the first roll. Nice. So that's 2 minefields. That's more minefields cleared in this game than we have in the past 5 years.
That's not true. We did it when we did the chain of command with the Americans. I cleared the minefields right off.
Oh. Okay, so...
Again, I'm an engineer.
It's, okay. Well, there you go. You got to be an engineer to do it, apparently. So he's cleared more minefields by himself than the rest of us combined in the past 10 years.
And I'm going to burn a chain of command point.
Point or dice?
Dice.
Okay.
I'm going to move that jump off point up.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Instead, he'd move that, the one back there up to there. So now he'll be able to deploy... He's got 1 squad left. He can deploy it into the rat bastard. Is that everything?
Yeah, not a dice.
Hey, look at that.
A 5.
And 4. Andre's waiting. He hates playing defense like this.
Double phase.
And 2 twos.
Oh, perfect.
And a 5. Besterman has moved the gun up. Next German phase.
Hey,
another German.
Oh, and this one's good.
Wasn't he supposed to drop a die?
Yeah, so drop one of those threes.
Okay.
So, so a 2 and a 3. Or two. Drop whichever one you want, I guess.
I'll drop the 2.
Okay. Just because we never...
We're going to move the gun up to the edge of the fence.
Okay.
Oh, I've got to do it that way. Yeah, that's enough.
Inches. The gun has moved up to here. The armor car moved flat out 7 inches. Did you add one per...
Oh, no.
You're on the road?
3 more.
He was...
2 more. I dropped the lowest die.
Oh.
He was... So he's going to be there. Okay. And that's it. We're saying 2 double phases in a row, you're done.
Okay.
Woo!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yahtzee!
Andre has moved the boys over here. Rearrange the squad, flip the brand over, and he's going to try to drop a smoke by that building. It's a hit. It's a... Andre's smoke has landed there. German fails. 1, 2, 3, 3, 6. Festerman has ordered his squad out, and he moved out with them, and then he put the gun on overwatch. And then over there, the armored car has gone on overwatch. Andre's phase. 1, 1, 4, 5, 6. So see, Andre, without the Wargaming World dice, you've rolled a lot less double phases.
This is true, and it's...
A 2-inch mortar just dropped a smoke on the building. So there it sits. German phase. Double. Oh,
triple,
man.
Phase. End of turn.
Goodbye, oh, man, smoke. My smoke.
20 minutes of deciding where to land the smoke,
oh,
and it,
man,
goes away.
That was an entire, what, 2 hours of gaming to get that smoke out there, and it just...
And then a 1 and a 3.
Like a poof of smoke.
Vesterman has ordered that squad up. Half of them made it over the fence. The other half are behind. End of turn. Smoke
end
comes
of
off. All the overwatches are going to come off.
I'll just go right.
We'll drop one, and your last double phase. Well, for now.
For now.
Okay.
1, 2, 4, 5. So Vesterman has ordered his boys.
No, it's that one.
Him and his boys over the fence. So there they are. Meanwhile, over there with the 3, that junior leader just put the squad on overwatch. And that's it. So it's double phase time.
Oh,
I'm sensing
there.
It. Yeah, I knew it.
It is.
It is double phase time.
It's going to be ugly. It's going to be ugly.
And I got stuff.
And
damn.
He's got stuff to do. Okay, here we go. So blue leader, that's Corporal Alan Downs, has come out. Andre's been waiting. He's got the 2 entrenchments for the full section. They're going to pop up out of nowhere, and we're going to light these dudes up.
And
so it's going to be, this is the 7 rifleman squad, or 7 rifleman rifle team.
Okay.
Plus the Bren. Plus
Bren
the
is...
plus Downs. So you're going to have 8 shots plus 6.
14.
14 shots
eight
from here.
Plus... So 7 for the rifles, right?
Yep.
7 for the rifles.
1
and
for the junior leader.
How many for the Bren?
6.
6. And then the junior leader's just got a rifle?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So he adds in 1 more shot.
Ah, okay. I was looking for a SMG with 4 shots or something there.
Right, but before anything happens, the German junior leader is going to interrupt.
Senior leader.
The Vesterman is going to interrupt.
Gonna like...
He's going to order them to run into the house.
Oh, yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah, they're going to make it. So, okay. Crisis averted for the Germans. But
woo-hoo.
That doesn't get him any closer to the board edge. But he did get out of the line of fire of those. So it's good that you didn't commit your second squad, because...
That would have...
Or your last squad, I should say. Then he would have known exactly where you were.
Yes.
So instead of firing, the Germans ducked into the building. So Downs has said, okay, boys, overwatch. Just cover everything. So that was a 3. So Andre still got a 2 and a 4 to go. The boys anti-tank rifle has moved tactically up to get line of sight on the armored car.
Can it move tactically and fire?
No, it's not
going
to fire this time.
Okay.
Meanwhile, Downs is going to have the Bren try to drive off the armored car. So roll me 2d6 there, Robert. You need a 5 or a 6 on one of them.
No.
No. Okay, so roll another d6 for me. Ooh. So what's a net no net hits or whatever the hell it is?
5 on no net hits. Equal hits and saves, 1d6 shock.
One shock, 1d6 reverse.
1d6 shock, that'd be hell of a...
Woohoo! 4 shock!
Alright! He runs off.
You didn't think I could destroy him.
That'd be hell of a thing. So he does pull back 4 inches and takes a shock.
Mm-hmm.
So not bad. Not bad for Downs' section. Alright. Next phase, Andre.
Okay.
You're supposed to drop one.
Drop a 2.
Yeah, drop a 4. That's fine.
Drop a 4.
Drop a 3 on 2 of them. That's fine.
Drop a 1. It really doesn't matter.
Okay. We'll drop a 4. Okay. And then he's got 1, 2, 2, 4. The boy's AT rifle. Gonna take a shot at the car. Needing a 9.
Woohoo!
I think you're out of ammo. And he's got a Two twos and a four left. That's it for Andre. All right, Germans, what do you got? Two, two, four, five, six. Robert's just not doing anything, but putting someone on Overwatch, and that's it.
Yeah, so...
So the attack is...
It's coming, if I can get a chain of command dice or two.
Two, three, three, four, four. Andre's going to fire the boy's AT rifle, needing a nine. Oh, so close. And those are the four, I'm assuming.
Yeah. And I don't think I can. Yeah, I'm nowhere close.
He's out of
here.
Ammo now. Is that it?
And I don't have a one. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Germans. Can't do nothing again this time. Two, no. Two, three, five, six. The 2-2-2, first of all, first thing you need to do, 2-2-2 is going to fire at the boys. 6 HE.
Five hits.
Wow.
No cover.
Yeah, dropping
no
it
cover.
Down.
Nope.
Why not? It reduces cover by one.
Yeah, so I'm in light cover.
Why would you be in hard cover?
Because I went tactical.
Oh, you are tactical. No, but you
can't
shot.
Be tactical and fire.
Yeah, you shot.
You can't?
No.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you did shoot, so that removes your tactical.
Oh, well.
No, if you could just go on tactical and shoot forever.
I'm like, they're laying down.
No cover, Andre. Stop trying to talk us out of it.
Okay, no cover.
Only two shock. Wow. Okay, that was what.
Shouldn't have been anything, but okay.
Yep.
That's all he's going to do. So the attacker is not moving. One, two, three, four, six.
Yeah, I'm building. You're not going to let me cheat?
So the AT rifle has moved back tactically, and then Tudor has pulled off the two shock. Now everyone's out of line of sight. Now it's the German phase. One, two, three, one, five.
Perfect.
So the 2-2-2 has moved up, and he's going to try to drive him off with some Overwatch fire, so needing a five.
No.
No. Roll a d6.
He rolls it.
Roll a d6, Andre. A four.
Halt and engage fire next phase.
No problem there.
So I get to shoot him.
You do get to shoot him.
Six HE.
Yeah. He's got a. He can fire now, and then he's got a. But he can't move.
Yeah, I have
shoot.
To engage him.
So roll it in here.
I thought four was the same thing I got last time.
Nope, you got a five last time.
Oh, man.
Nice. Four hits.
Four hits, Andre. Soft cover. Split them up.
Okay.
Two and two.
Rifles.
One dead.
Just nothing. A dead rifle. Check then, see if it's downs.
No.
No. Not downs. But a dead rifleman, so that was a three.
Mm-hmm.
He still got two ones and a two left. Last thing he did was just move his gun up. Into the road there, and I think that's it. So, Andre, your phase. Two, three, four, four, six. With the two, can you? I don't think you can do that with the two. I think
you'd use the three.
Three.
There's a three. Oh, I didn't see the three. Okay, so try and drive the armored car off again.
Oh, I did.
Again.
It's okay, roll a.
Something better than
this
a four.
Third time in a row.
Stays where it is and engages you.
Okay, so
awesome.
Same thing.
Okay.
And is that it, Andre?
No, I'm gonna go ahead and move the. How close am I to being able to
fire at the car?
Fire at the car. So
not very. You don't have to go
about
very
8
far.
Inches. So
Andre's moved up a D6.
Okay.
He needs a 10 on 2D6. Oh, he got
it.
Oh, man. So two, roll two dice, Andre. One.
Hit.
And then Robert roll a...
Two saves. Spanged it.
Bounced. Okay. That's it for you? Is that right, Andre?
Yeah.
Okay, German face.
He's wondering... Aren't you guys
not? Two, three, five, five, six.
Hey!
First thing he's going to do is get his mandatory stop and engage fire out of the way. So he's going to use the armored car.
Two hits.
Two hits. Andre is not here.
Yes, he is.
Okay, rifle. So split him up.
Don't care. Dead.
Ooh, dead on the brand
game. See if it's the leader.
Yeah.
No.
So a dead Bren team.
Okay.
He, like Andre said, he's getting whittled down. So that was a 3. Andre's face. I gotta tell you, man, this is the slowest attack I've seen develop. Not saying something.
Has it developed?
We've seen some slow attacks, but this is the slowest. 3 1s and a 4.
Okay.
With one of the ones, we're taking another pop. Ah, it's a miss. Another pop at the boys, it's a miss. Is that it, Andre?
Yep.
Okay. Come on, Germans. Time to make your push.
Mm-hmm.
2 3 2s, yeah. Not getting a 3 doesn't help. Westerman has come out solo over there. And that's all he's going to do. So this, your phase, Andre. Someone's got to be attacker. Maybe Andre should go on the attack here.
Give me a couple double phases. We'll turn it around here.
Nope.
Ooh, but I
one,
might
two,
get
three,
a
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 again. All Andre's going to do is fire the boys again.
Nope.
No. That's not a hit. Okay. Germans.
I guess I so could fire the machine gun again, too.
Okay, try to drive it off the...
All right, so that's something Robert has to do here.
No.
You blocked it. Okay, your face. Finally blocked one of those. 2, 3, 3, 4, 5. The Westerman has moved back. Got in range of the MG-34. They moved up.
They hauled ass.
He moved them up. And then he's going to fire the armored car back at Corporal Downs.
5 hits.
5 hits. Okay, split them up, Andre.
Rifles. Shock.
1 shock.
Others.
2 shock.
2 shock. Yeah, I guess over time, yeah. I mean, you could sit there and pick away.
They're going to move that gun again, hugging the fence.
Okay.
3 inches that way.
That'll do it. Your phase, Andre. One, 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay, here we go again. The boys' anti-tank rifle. No, oh, that's a hit. It's a hit. 2 against 2, so roll your 2d6, Andre.
No hits.
Nothing.
Bounced it. And then these guys, so roll 2 more, Robert, because he's going to have downs fire. Ooh,
okay. D6. See what happens. Oh, we got to shoot you again.
So he's got to stop and engage
me.
Fire again. No problem there. is that it, Andre?
No, I've got smoke, so I'm going to drop smoke.
Drop a smoke, okay? Go for it. It's going to drift.
6 inches
short. Now he's blocked the line of sight from his Bren team to the armored car. So we're going to go ahead and say that stop and engage fire is now null and void. So
null
German
void.
Face. That car could get off the table. Maybe. Double phase.
Mm-hmm.
All right. 1, 3, 4. Westerman has moved himself up that range of the MG-34, which ran all the way up here.
Mm-hmm.
He moved 2d6 down the road. Got to there. He's going to fire a half-effect machine gun at the boys.
Nothing.
3 1s. Yeah,
wow.
That's not going to do it.
Second phase.
Obviously a bumpy road. Next phase. Drop one. Not bad.
Not
2, 2, 3, 4. That car can move again.
Through the open field.
And
Kopke has ordered the machine gun up. So he's got a full squad, a machine gun, an armored car. Meanwhile, Westerman hauled ass back over here, ordered the gun to move up.
And with a 3, I'm bringing in the last squad. Overwatch, top story of the Red Bastard.
All right. They're making a push. How do you know they're making a push, Andre?
The reserves came in.
No. If you see a guy, if you see a bunch of guys running at you, screaming and shooting, they're making a push.
Yeah, but they're not screaming and shooting, and they're not running at me.
That's true. We deduced that they're making a push because they're all over here. Last squad has come into the Rat Bastard, and that is it for the Germans, I believe.
I don't know.
You got a guy here. Is this?
Oh, he's one of the another member of the squad.
Okay, so all the German squads are on now. One in here, two by the Rat Bastard, and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
So this is it.
So I'm going to declare my off-board bombardment. It's a 9-inch template.
Okay, it's got an armor panel.
Yeah, but the Stukas that work here.
Orbital bombardment.
Oh, they drove off my...
No, they killed it.
Exterminatus. hey, 3-3s and 2-2s. Boys, back at the armored car.
Nothing.
That's a miss. And Andre has a squad off the board still. Plus, he has Elsden, his platoon leader. Lieutenant Elsden hasn't even come on yet.
Mm-hmm.
All right, your face. Are you still going, Andre? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Andre just used Corporal Downs to pull a couple of shock.
Okay. Your face.
1-2-5-5-6. First thing. The 2-2-2 is going to fire at the boys, which has been a constant pain in the ass
for the
Germans.
In the open.
In the open. Dead. Dead in the shock. It's the unkillable boys. So that was a 3, a 2, and a 1. So
I'm done.
That's it. That's it. All right, Andre. Double phase.
No. Ooh, no, one, but two. Look at that. I got more chain of command dice than the last 5 phases.
The boys has just moved back with the one, back by the piggery there, and that's it. No one seems to want to make a decisive move. I guess no one. Andre's not doing it.
I'd love to make a defending. Decisive move.
He's been wanting to counterattack all night, and I kept talking him out of it. 3-4s, a 1, and a 2. They moved out in the street from the building, blocked by the smoke. Car went on overwatch. Copy ordered them over, put the gun on overwatch. These guys are on overwatch already. Okay, that's it. Andre's phase.
That is not a double phase.
2-3-4-4-5. So Andre has moved, Corporal Downs moved out. Elston came in finally. And pulled some shock. They only got a 2-inch move out of the entrenchment, sadly. Meanwhile, Tudor has rearranged his squad. The boys is on overwatch. Is that it?
Yeah, that's going to be it.
All right, German phase. I can see it developing now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Double phase.
Double
1-1-3.
Well, that's probably a game
Could
ender.
Be good. I wouldn't say ender, but...
After my whiff?
He's still got to get off the table. He's still got a squad off the board.
1 point
shock. Kopke has ordered this squad. They ran up to here. Took a couple shock. He ordered them to run up. They got a shit move, but they did get within 4. So right now, he's shut down both of these. And then Kopke's last order is going to pull one of the shock off of one of these teams.
Machine gun team.
We got a shock on each, shock on the rifles, and another
phase.
Pull a die.
I did.
Okay. Oh,
two fours.
Two fours.
That's all I needed.
Is it though?
Oh yeah, because here's what we're gonna do.
First thing that happened, the first order was Kopke ordered the squad to move down. They did. They made it to touch the jump off point. And Andre's going to fire his overwatch with his boys AT rifle. It's a hit. HE1. So it's going to be one hit at no cover there, Robert.
Okay.
Point of shock.
Point of shock.
We were supposed to.
You're supposed to kill the officer, Kopke.
Supposed to kill the officer, but.
I was supposed to kill Kopke. It didn't even happen.
Okay.
All right,
next.
So that's two of Kopke's.
His third order, they're running up those stairs into that building.
Okay. See what you get.
Perfect.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
all right, so
I can save it for
Downs. He's going to use his chain of command dice. Andre is, and Corporal Downs' squad is going to charge. It's a desperation thing here. He's going to charge in to. He should make it. No, he made it. Five inches.
Yeah, he's got to be within 4 inches of me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, actually, if it was four, well.
Yeah, he's made it. We're going to do fisticuffs now. Through the fence.
Close combat, it's getting a lot nastier than that.
Through the fence. Okay, here we go. Corporal Downs, 13 dice. Not bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So keep the sixes and fives separate.
Three sixes.
Three sixes and two fives.
Okay, three sixes and two fives. So go ahead and roll yours.
25. So I got 1, 2, 3.
That's it.
Four.
That's good. It's over.
Seven.
I concede.
I get 7 fives. And then another 6 sixes.
Yeah, the whole squad has been wiped out. So Downs, Corporal Downs' squad section has been obliterated.
Elston is dead.
Elston's dead. You would have to roll for your leader.
Okay.
It doesn't matter.
He's dead. He's hit.
He loses a... He's just wounded.
It doesn't matter.
All right. All right, in the end, Downs' section has been wiped out, and Andre is going to concede. He can't deploy from... that jump-off point. There was another one somewhere over here, wasn't
right
there?
Right there.
Oh, right here. It can't deploy from that one. And these guys are weakened, and they got all this, so the Germans are going to be able to just push right off the edge, and we'll come back and wrap it up. In the end, we didn't roll for the bad things, but Andre would have rolled for section lost, two leaders wiped out, maybe captured, and then Robert was saying he would have went up there, caught that one, he had this one. He could have ended the turn. It should have been two more.
Or he could have just finished the objective and run
off. Or
he
could have just gone off. Yeah. So it was a good job. Good job,
man. The old-fashioned way.
No, it was a good job. It took a long time to set up, but in the end it paid off, and it was a good job.
Well, Lieutenant Westerman fought in the last war, so.
Lieutenant Westerman and Kopke. So this is two games in a row that the Germans have just crushed the French and now the British. And this is even the weaker of the German platoons. But yeah, it was a good game. It took a long time to develop, but it was a lot of movement, a lot of setting up. But in the end, it paid off. What can I say? I know I was kind of giving Robert a bad time about being so slow, but what can you say? I mean, he did win. So there's that. But yeah, great job by Robert. Andre... I don't know what to say about Andre's thing.
What thing? I didn't do anything.
Yeah,
no thing.
It was a weird game. It was different because the first game that we played this on this map, we were playing Hasty Defense, and we're playing this direction. And Andre got me kind of flat-footed. I was split up, and that was it. This time we were playing along this way, and I was thinking, okay, going this way is going to be a lot harder.
But it was. It took a long time. It
took a long time, but he got up here and some timely double phases again. And I think cutting off the double phases at two is not the end of the world. Because the last thing that either you needed was a third double phase in a row
I could have used couple double phases.
It's always handy.
I did roll another one. And
it's always handy.
So it would have been useful. But,
So Robert's plan, since I've heard both plans, his plan was to go along this edge, clear these minefields, and head off the board this way, and that's exactly what he did. Andre's plan was to react, but he also had designs on placing guys over there in case he tried to go that way. He brought four of his 7 points were for entrenchments. And he never even brought his last section on, which was going to be Beersford's section, and they never even made it. So, but once you got these two jump-off points shut down, I mean, he had one over there, but what the hell is that going to do?
Well, that last double phase just ended it in a heartbeat. I mean, the game went critical as soon as you made your final push. I whiffed on that my move to try and outflank you, and then you double phase me. I mean, it's when you make your final push and you double phase, it's over. It's
like I said, a timely double phase.
Yeah.
Well, because it was. They were vulnerable in the open, and the rat bastard. I mean, they need to knock some walls, some windows into some of these. But
you should.
It really is that once you knock these jump off points off, you can't deploy anymore, and that's. Yeah.
And he was counting on that third section, Beardsford section, is popping up in hard cover. Well, too.
I was expecting it to
right in the middle of the road there.
Probably be somewhere, you know, in here.
And that would have been hard to overcome.
But it was well,
not really. But
well, the move with Downs' section out and then we got a double one didn't help.
Yeah, that didn't.
Well, help. Yeah, if I'd have been able to get into that building across from the Rat Bastard and had you know, the threat of a flanking maneuver. Mm-hmm. I've also got the gun I can take and the engineering units, and I could threaten your force morale and that rear jump off point. It was a real threat, but that I didn't make it to the building, and then you double phased, and it was like, well, I kind of had one shot at it, and it just slipped through my fingers.
Yep. Well, it happens like that, but yeah, good job to Robert and the Germans. So that's two games in a row now. The Germans have beaten the Allies, so they're going to make it to Dunkirk, and that's it. So yeah, it was a great game. Thanks to Robert and Andre for coming over. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and call it now. It's been a long game. It's been a long night. Probably a long video on top of everything. So, again, check our Facebook group if you want to get in, see what's happening behind the scenes here and to see what's happening with just all the Tabletop CP members that are busy hobbying away, just like I am. And then our Patreon page as well, where we have a lot of stuff just for patrons. We got full campaigns. We got videos. Behind the scenes, even more in-depth behind the scenes, Andre.
Oh,
more than I said before. So it's even more behind the scenes.
Behind
the scenes, behind those other scenes. The
I'm first like, ones. Man, we're not going to see you naked or anything here, are we?
It gets to there. We might at some point.
Okay. No, well, the full Monty.
Anyway, yeah. So that's it. It's been a long night. Thanks to these guys for coming over. And thanks for watching, guys. So we'll see you next time. We'll be right back.